Hello, I am Jojy, KV of Bharata College, Thrikkakara. I would like to make a small evaluation of what is literary criticism. Literary criticism is an overall term for defining, classifying, analyzing, and interpreting, sometimes evaluating a work of literature. The first point is defining a literary work. Defining a literary work means we would like to come to the different genres and what kind of literary work that is. And second one is classifying. We will be making different categories of the literature. And again, the third one is analyzing a literary work. Fourth point is most important thing in the literary criticism, that is interpreting a literature. Interpreting means the interpretation can be of the reader, and also it is based upon the writer, and it is based upon the universe, etc. So lastly, it is evaluating. So we have seen defining, classifying, analyzing, interpreting, and evaluating a literary work. So these are the five stages of literary criticism. So literary criticism can be also categorized into two kinds. Number one is theoretical criticism, and the second one is practical or applied criticism. Literary criticism are of two types. Number one is theoretical criticism. Second one is practical criticism or applied criticism. So the most important theories are starting from Aristotle's Poetics, which is from the 4th century, that we have already seen. So here, from Aristotle's theories to the right, modern and postmodern theories are interpreted, evaluated, and classified, etc., upon the quality of a work. Whether it is a classic or a modern one, we are making the theory and studying the theory, and also in the application level, we are coming. In the modern criticism, I.A. Richards comes as the foremost person in the Principles of Literary Criticism, which is published in 1924. With I.A. Richards, the practical criticism starting in English language and literature. The landmarks of theoretical criticism in the first half of 20th century is starting with I.A. Richards' practical criticism. Which was published in 1924. That is the most important book in the applied criticism or practical criticism. So in practical criticism, a frequent distinction is made between impressionistic criticism and also a judicial criticism. So basically, it is again classified into two types. Number one is impressionistic criticism. So again, we would come to the what is impressionistic criticism. So it is based upon your impression. What do you feel? The words we understand by just by impression. You decide by from feelings and not from reason. Reason is not at all important there. Your impression is important there. From the impressions of a number of things in the mind. So that is known as impressionistic criticism. So William Hazlitt is speaking about it in a very frequent way. Then second one is judicial criticism. In the judicial criticism, we are critically analyzing with our reason, and there are some judicious point of view in it, and we analyze the things with reference to the individual judgment upon the specified criteria of the literary excellence. We are coming to the literary excellence based upon some specific evaluating terms. That is the judicial criticism. So these are the two kinds of criticism in the practical level, based upon your impression and upon your reasoning power. So traditional criticism and applied criticism as based upon are distinguished according to whether it is focusing on which element we are focusing. So there are four important things. Number one is the work itself. So whether we are focusing upon the work or whether we are focusing upon the outer world, whether we are focusing upon the author himself or herself, etc., we are classifying the different kinds of criticism. If you are focusing upon the universe, that kind of criticism is known as mimetic criticism. We are making the reflection of the universe there. So if it is based upon the reflection of the universe, as Matthew Arnold says, criticism or poetry is the criticism of life. It is the reflection of the universe. It is the reflection of the realities of the life. So that is known as universe is important. That kind of criticism is known as mimetic criticism. If the author is given importance, that kind of criticism is known as expressive kind of criticism. Expressive criticism. The third one is, if the audience is given importance, for example, reader-oriented theories are there, it is pragmatic criticism. So these are the three kinds of criticism. Basically, then if the work itself is important as a objective criticism, if work is given there, it is objective criticism. We are not concerned about the man and the milieu there, or we are not concerned about the author, or we are not concerned about the reader there. The work is closely analyzed. A close reading of the text is given there in the objective kind of criticism. So these are the four kinds of criticism, basically. So I would like to say once again, the mimetic criticism. So as you know, mimetic criticism is basically concerned about the theories of Aristotle, Plato onwards, and right from the BC onwards, these theories are there. The most important theoreticians in BC regarding literature, art, etc. are Plato and Aristotle. They remain the most important figures even now. So pragmatic criticism is the second one, in which the reader is the most important person there. He sometimes analyzing, interpreting, evaluating according to his whims and fancies. Sometimes he is not concerned about the realities of the life. He is not at all concerned about the author or the period in which he is saying, the historical fact, the psychological facts, etc. are not at all important there. So pragmatic criticism is based upon the reader and how he is viewing the things there. Whether it is a poem or a drama, drama is viewed by an audience. The audience theories are also there, important. The third one is expressive criticism. The expressive means the author is important there, the dramatist is important there, the playwright is important there, the artist is important there. So the expressive criticism. So the last one is objective criticism. Objective criticism, as we have seen, it is the work is given importance there. The only work is given importance there. So the other factors are not at all taken into consideration in analyzing a poetry. So there comes the importance of I.A. Richards that we have already seen, the practical criticism which was formulated and popularized by him. A book known as The Practical Criticism itself was published in 1924, which is a crucial thing in giving training to the students in the practical criticism. So these are the four kinds of criticism in the general introduction. When we come to a work, we are always concerned about these four aspects of criticism, four divisions, classifications of the criticism. A work can be viewed in these four different categories: mimetic criticism, pragmatic criticism, expressive criticism, and objective criticism. Thank you.